Put you, Dr. Sabri Saj.
Sir, thank you, Dr. Nirmal. As you have rightly said, it is very difficult to cover everything in detail within 10 minutes. So what I am going to do is highlight the tips what one should or one must follow in a prison theater and for instrument sterilization. I don't have any financial interest in this presentation. So coming to the cleaning of the operation theater, cleaning is very important because cleaning removes contaminants, dusts, and organic matter. Dusts are very, very notorious because they contain the microorganisms. So what is known is a clean and dry surface, there is always chance of natural death of bacteria. So bacteria cannot grow in a dry surface. So we have to see that the surface remains dry all the time. Anything wet inside the OT is to be considered as unsterile, because wet areas always carry bacteria and they grow inside the wet area only. So one important principle is there should not be any brooming inside the OT, because that increases bacterial flora in the environment. So what we have to do is the floor should be either cleaned with a vacuum cleaner, not domestic cleaner, but hospital vacuum cleaner, and wet mopping. Wet mopping is the simplest and easiest thing to be done. And it is known that a simple detergent reduces the bacterial flora by 10%, 80%, and adding a disinfectant to that, it increases to 95%. So what we commonly use in our hospital is a 2% bacillocid. That is 100 ml of the bacillocid mixed with 5 liter of water. So that provides a good disinfectant solution for cleaning of the floor, wall, and also the instruments and other surfaces. So we have to maintain a daily, weekly, and monthly cleaning schedule. So daily, so what we have to clean daily is the walls and roof. No, walls and floor has to be cleaned daily twice, before starting of the surgery and after ending of the session of the surgery. The refrigerator or flat surface of any OT table and other horizontal surfaces have to be cleaned daily. Then sink also to be cleaned daily. OT furniture inside the OT table and the surgeon's stool have to be also cleaned with alcohol spray daily. And weekly, all the articles inside the OT should be removed and the floor should be mopped properly weekly. And in monthly schedule, we have to wash the OT floor with detergent and disinfectant once in a month. Then every week, the AC filter has to be cleaned. And HU and other filters and water sources have to be cleaned in every month. So this is how we have to prepare a protocol for our institutions, what is to be killed, what is to be done daily, and what is to be done weekly, and what is to be done monthly. Now coming to fumigation or fogging, that is now they are commonly used. Formalin fumigation is discouraged. So what we use is 2% again bacillocid, that is 100 ml in 5 liter of water, and room to be kept closed for 6 hours. And it is done once a week. Ultraviolet radiation is also another advantage of environment cleaning. It can be done after the OT is over for 12 to 16 hours. The light is switched on when last person leaves the OT and is switched off 2 hours before the first person enters for the safety of the person who is entering first. So there has to be 2 hours gap between the stoppage of the light and entering of any individual inside. Now, microbiological monitoring is also essential. We have to take swabs from 7 locations, from OT table head end, overhead lamp, floor walls, floor below the head end of the table, instrument trolley, AC duct, and microscope handle. And this is to be sent for culture every 2 weeks as recommended by NPCB guideline. Then for monitoring air quality, settle plate method has to be done. We have to put blood agar or separate agar dishes inside the OT. And again, that is to be sent for culture, and bacteria count has to be done to ensure that the OT environment is sterile. And the most important thing is all these are to be documented properly in a register so that this can be verified later on. Then coming to the care of surgical instrument, again, it starts with cleaning of the instruments, and cleaning should start immediately as soon as the surgical case is over. not at the end of the surgical session, all the instrument to be cleaned. Then after cleaning, we have to inspect each instrument. Then we have to properly store and package for either for storage or for sterilization. Then every procedure has to be properly documented. Then cleaning should start after a case is finished. The blades are to be wiped clean and cannulas are to be flossed, because any visco or any lens tissue inside the cannula, there is chance of the blockage and damage of the cannula. Then after wiping and cleaning in the OT table itself, those instruments are to be transferred to be washed under running water first. Then there, the sharp and blunt instruments are to be separated and kept at different places. Needle holder, scissors, and atripers, all hinged instruments must be completely open to clean inside the jaws. And cleaning can be done by ultrasound cleaner, although it is not a must, but four bowel technique can be also used, in which in two bowels we can keep any like Savlon, and then two bowels should be kept to wash or rinse the instruments. We can use a soft toothbrush for cleaning, thorough cleaning of the instruments. Joints, locks, serrations should be cleaned well, because these are the points of corrosion and where the rusting starts. Enzymatic cleaning solutions help in dislodging that, and that is advised once a month. Cotton wool should not be used as it damages the tips of instruments. Then there is an automated cleaning instrument for these tubings. So PECO tubings, it is better to use the automated cleaning instrument. Otherwise, it is to be flushed by manual flushing with a 20 ml syringe with distilled water, and also two times with distilled water, three times with distilled water, and three times with air, so that that is to be cleaned and dried also. Drying up instrument is very important, because any moisture present in the instrument will lead to rusting and corrosion of the instrument. So that is to be removed. It should not be wiped with a cloth, because that can damage the surface finish and sharpness of the instrument. So it is to be done by aeration or by hot air, by high flow jet air pump. Then after cleaning, all the instruments are to be inspected for cleanliness, whether it is properly cleaned or not. Is there any corrosion or stain on the instruments? Is there any defect in the alignment or cutting of the, in case of scissors? The cutting edge has to be smooth. Otherwise, if we not check that, we will catch a very sorry figure during surgery, because at that point of time, when you see or feel that it is not working, that gives a very bad impression. So hinged instruments are to be checked for jaw alignment. Micro scissor tip should be smooth and in alignment and able to cut through one thickness of surgical globe. Dissecting forceps should meet at the tip. There should not be any gap at the tip. Grooved forceps, when held up to the light, should show a perfect circle at the tip. Needle holder tips must meet, allowing for suture to be held well. There should not be any gap between the jaws. Blades should be sharp and smooth edge, and cannula should be flushed with air to ensure patency and dryness. Then in case of corrosion, there are certain solutions, sodium nitrate solutions are available to remove the corrosion. Instrument stains are found out as discoloration of the metal at some places. Some stains can be rubbed off with a rubber eraser. An instrument not rinsed thoroughly will stain. So we have to see that all the instruments, after being used any detergent or disinfectant, are rinsed thoroughly. And manufacturers' recommendations of soaking items must not be exceeded. That should be properly adhered to. Then instruments should be stored in the sterilizing tray properly and lined with soft silicone mat. A dry, well-ventilated cupboard is used if it is going to be stored for a long time. Silicone gel can be placed on the sleeves, as that is hygroscopic. Instruments should not touch each other. Protective tips of soft silicone tubing of the proper size should be used for sharp instruments. Do not use rubber or plastic protective tip, as they melt during autoclaving and cause damage of the instrument. So storing of the instruments are also very important for storage, and also for sterilization purpose also. We have to keep the instruments in a proper manner so that it will be properly sterile and also there will not be damage to any instrument. Then sterilization, we use or advocate two processes only. What is one is steam under pressure or autoclave, commonly done by us, and ETO sterilization. No chemical sterilization is to be discouraged. So classically, class B autoclave is advised because there is scope for vacuum removal, and we can ensure that proper sterilization occurs inside. And the timing is 15 minutes at 121 degree centigrade, or 10 minutes at 126, or 3 minutes at 134 degree centigrade at 30 pound of pressure. And then ETO is also another method that is to be used for tubings, PECO tubings or vitrectomy tubings have to be ETO sterilized, and other sharp instrument also can be sterilized by ETO. For short cycle in between cases, we can use high speed autoclave, or a single drum autoclave can be used at 134 degree temperature, 30 pound pressure for 7 to 10 minutes. Then certain sterilizer indicators we have to use. There are biological, mechanical, and chemical indicators. Biological indicators are the most effective and efficient to know the sterility of the instrument. But the problem with that is we don't get immediately or instantly the report. That takes time. So mechanical and chemical indicators have to be used. Mechanical is to see and check the gauges, the temperature gauge, the pressure gauge, and these are to be documented properly. And chemical indicators are used inside the drum, inside the package, to see that the proper temperature and time is maintained during the sterilization process. So this gives a rough idea that the things are properly done. So there are six types of indicators. We commonly use this class 1 and class 2 indicator for type B autoclaves, biotic strip. But class 5 indicator gives or maintains a lot more parameters. So class 5 indicator is advised to be used inside the autoclave. So all items must be labeled with the date of sterilization and date of expiry, because that is to be mentioned properly. Once a package has been opened, it is no longer considered sterile, whether or not its contents are used. Items must be inspected before use to ensure there is no tear, puncture, or open package. Any weight article is to be considered unsterile. Don't store non-sterile item along with sterile items. If sterility of any item cannot be assessed, so it should be taken as unsterile and should be re-sterilized or discarded. So to conclude, written protocols for instrument cleaning and sterilization is a must, and we have to maintain that. Proper documentation of the daily and weekly disinfection procedures and culture report are absolutely essential. There has to be no chemical sterilization inside the OT. A pest control program is necessary to reduce the risk of infestations. So OT sterilization and proper instrument maintenance can provide an infection-free environment and quality care for the patients. Thank you all. Thank you very much for your presence here.